Here, a long tradition of excellence in biomedical research took root and has kept growing. Thanks to their innovative vision, dynamic drive, and determination, our dozens of devoted and passionate research workers have achieved the worldwide fame that they enjoy today. This exceptional place is called the Quebec Heart and Lung Institute, a tertiary care hospital affiliated to Laval University.
With time and effort, our research center with components in cardiology, respirology, and obesity has become an international benchmark. Our mission is discovery, to prevent, to cure, through creating, sharing, and applying knowledge for the benefit of the population and individuals with cardiovascular, respiratory, and obesity-related diseases.
Since 1955, research at the Quebec Heart and Lung Institute has evolved thanks to visionary scientists who have paved the way for the Institute to become what it is today. These builders have led the growth of the Institute in response to major priorities of the health sector. Their vision was to build a culture of cooperation and integration of their various fields. 60 years of research and innovation, during which the Institute's ultra-specialties have oriented research themes for the greater benefit of the patients.
Over the last decade, the Research Center has tripled its space and acquired major equipment. Cutting-edge infrastructures are compulsory to recruit and retain the best scientists.
Thanks to its exceptional growth, the Institute has become a leader in the treatment and prevention of cardiovascular, respiratory, and obesity-related diseases, recognized worldwide as among today's major societal health challenges. The Institute is an international leader in the fight against such diseases, with an integrated research model aligning research components with clinical departments to link scientific discovery to patient care. The Institute is the only hospital in Canada to regroup ultra-specialized care and research in cardiology, respirology, and obesity.
Our research center has experienced a tremendous growth in recent years.
Close to 800 people work at the Institute today, three times as many as 15 years ago. Close to 150 investigators conduct clinical and fundamental research here. During this period, those specialists have published over 4,500 scientific articles in top medical and scientific journals. They are also committed to training dozens of postgraduate students, postdoctoral fellows, and clinical instructors.
Our research center is a remarkable training environment. To us, training the next generation is a priority. It is a prerequisite to the development of the society and to our international stature. Our research center is an exceptional landmark. It is an asset for the province of Quebec and Canada in the fight against chronic societal diseases.
Uniting the research components of cardiology, respirology, and obesity has created an exceptional environment for discovery. These components are moving forward under the inspiring leadership of the research specialists who oversee their management.
Our research in cardiology has evolved around four large themes. The area of electrophysiology and management of arrhythmias has allowed us to be at the forefront of diagnosis, medical treatment, and of procedures to optimally manage an expanding group of patients due to the aging of the population. Treatment of coronary heart disease is also one of our strengths. This theme involves innovative approaches developed here at the Institute, such as access to coronary arteries through the radial artery. This novel procedure has allowed to reduce hospitalization time and is also more comfortable for patients. A large transarterial valve implantation program has also been developed and will change clinical practice in the area of heart valve disease replacement. Our investigators are also pioneers in the area of metabolic cardiology and prevention, with a multidisciplinary approach aiming at the optimal management of patients with heart disease or at high risk for cardiovascular complications. Finally, heart surgery has for a long time developed a very large clinical database, which allows our heart surgeons and our basic scientists to examine numerous relevant clinical and scientific questions, particularly in the area of heart valve diseases. This large research group, the largest in this area in Canada, enjoys an international reputation.
Our investigators are working to understand how the brain controls the balance between the input and output of energy, how some fat depots and expansion become a risk factor for cardiovascular and respiratory diseases, how to control a type of fat called beige or brown, which actually burns energy, how bariatric surgery not only reduces excess fat, but also cures diabetes, and how to prevent and treat obesity through novel nutritional and environmental approaches.
Researchers in respiratory medicine are interested in curing asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, sleep apnea, and pulmonary vascular diseases. We are also concerned about lung cancer, the most deadly cancer. Since we are working in a tertiary care center, we have the opportunity to access cohorts of individuals suffering from lung diseases who contribute on a daily basis to the progress of our research. We specialize in the evaluation and optimization of respiratory health of young athletes who need perfectly working lungs. Our leading-edge model involving patients in their treatment became a standard of care for asthmatic patients. We possess a rare expertise in the evaluation of air quality, an environmental cause of several lung diseases. Our researchers also actively try to discover how tobacco, the main enemy to respiratory health, affects lungs.
Sincere thanks to everyone who has contributed to our expansion. For me, it is a true privilege to lead such a research center whose social and medical relevance is manifest. The 60th anniversary moves us and strengthens our will to discover, to prevent, to cure. Long live the research center of the Institut Universitaire de Cardiologie et de Pneumologie de Québec.